GL coding. General ledger codes help you organize your expenses. Coding your non-PO invoices as you receive them makes it easier to track your company's spend. But of course, doing so takes some time. We can help facilitate this process and speed it up using FlexiCapture for invoices. So we can bring in a list of possible GL codes to a data set. And let's start off by looking at that. I'll click on Document Definitions, click on Edit, Document Definition Properties, and we'll go to the Datasets tab. And you can see a variety of datasets already populated, and GL codes is one of those datasets. And if we click on View, we can see a list of possible GL codes to use. While we're under the hood, let's go ahead and close that out. That can be updated as needed. Let's go ahead and go to the line items group of columns, and we'll find the GL code column. And let's take a look at its rules tab. And we have a check GL code database check. Let's take a look at that. This is rather easy to set up because the source is an actual data set. So we don't have to go to the trouble of making a connection to an external ODBC database, for instance. So that's pretty easy to set up. And then we simply need to add one field link where we're linking the GL code document field with the database field GL code. It's the only field in that data set. So we'll just shut this down. Don't want to save any changes that I made there. And we can go into our batch and take a look at what we have there. So we have three unprocessed documents. I'll go ahead and recognize them. Okay, that's complete. I've got one red flag error. I'll take a look at that. And it is the business unit name was not found. So I can just select that from a drop list. And that problem's resolved. I'll come back to this form. We'll go to the first form and take a look at the line items. And you can see we've got a GL code drop list here based on that database check. And I can simply choose the value from the drop list. And if that's going to pertain to all the rows, I could say copy value to all rows. And that's done. I can go to my next document. And let's pretend we need to code these separately. So of course, we can do that as well. And let's go to our last document. And we can code those very quickly. And we're all set with implementing GL coding within FlexiCapture for invoices.